हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। स्पेशली फॉर द फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, टिल नाउ वी हैव जस्ट हैड अ बेसिक केमिस्ट्री, राइट? बट दिस माइट बी अ लेंथी प्रोसेस फॉर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, सो दैट्स व्हाई व्हाट आई थॉट इज फ्रॉम टुडे ऑन लेट अस स्टार्ट or let us go with our syllabus itself. Why? Because already almost all, more than the basic things we have completed in these 1 month, 1 month of duration of time. So if I repeat those concepts which I have already completed as a basic, so it will be definitely it will be a boring and it will be a time wasting. So that's why what I thought is from today on, let us start our syllabus wise chemistry. And I have already given you a blueprint, right? So my simple request and suggestion is one, that from today on we are starting our syllabus. So my kind request you for you to you is that please, whatever I taught in the class, you definitely go and compare. Just these notes, or you can make a notes definitely while these classes. Otherwise, it's okay. But what are the concepts I will teach in a single class? Please go through the NCERT book. Why? Because NCERT is the very basic a book for all the competitive examination, right? So that's why whatever it may be, whatever the exam it may be a NEET exam, KCET exam, AIEEE, JEE, whatever it may be, for all those things, once if you start reading book, it will be just like a habit making. So that's why from the first day of your syllabus itself, I'm just requesting you, and today also I'm requesting you, just go through the NCERT book. Whatever I taught in a class, you just add more concepts by reading readers, right? Or else textbook, I can say, right? So with this, we will start the first chapter. You all know, and already I have given the blueprint. So some basic concepts of chemistry, right? Some basic concepts of chemistry. So this chapter is very simple, and in this chapter, whatever I taught during these basic classes, that part is only there, right? So with some extra points and some, I can say, some problems we come across in this chapter. After complete doing study on this chapter, one, we can come to know what is what is the importance of chemistry, what is the scope of chemistry, how many branches are present in the chemistry. And likewise, what we can study is what is atom, what is in actual matter, what are solids, what are gases, and what are liquids, what is the different chemical arrangement is present in the different forms of physical forms of matter. And not only that, one, we come to know how to calculate the percentage. If an element is present in the compound, then what is its contribution in that particular compound? So likewise, and generally with the percentage, one, we can calculate what is the molecular formula and the empirical formula, right? Likewise, what are the basic things are there for our chemistry, starting from atom to till the end, like electron, or else we can say valence electron, like till that we will extend our study with this chapter. So that's why this chapter is very easy and very important if you read it clearly, then this chapter will be very important. And already I have given you what is the how many marks we can cover after the completion of this chapter, right? So nearly this chapter is of 9 hour, and it carries nearly 9 marks in your main examination, right? So that's why this is also a very big chapter, I can say. And with this chapter one, we can expect more number of questions, right? And some of the questions are fixed questions in this chapter. So we will see everything during this chapter called Some Basic Concepts of Chemistry. Actually, my pen is not working. What happened to it? I don't know. Right? Anyway, so first of all, already we know what is chemistry, right? So in this chapter, before going to this chapter, we should start this chapter with the definition of our chemistry, right? So chemistry, already you know what is chemistry. Is nothing but the chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the studies of composition, property, and what I have given already composition, and then structure, and then properties of matter. So there are three things will come in this concept, that is structure, right? So structure means you already know what type of structure does the different matter has, right? So each and every matter present will not be having a same structure, right? So the structure may be different. They may be linear, they may be tetrahedral, octahedral, whatever it may be. We study first of all the structure of atom, and structure of any matter, and then properties like physical property, we can say, right? Very important properties like physical property, chemical property. That means in property one, we can say physical and chemical properties. So in physical property, we check the melting point and boiling point, right? And then what is its state? Whether the given matter is a solid or liquid or gas, right? And chemical means, say for example, if it is a water molecule, then water molecule, whether it reacts with other chemicals or not, we will see in the chemical properties. That means the different chemical reactions that particular element undergo with respect to other elements, right? So and finally we see very important part, that is the composition, right? These three parts are very important in our chemistry. So composition means what all it consists of, or else the matter is made up of with what. If chalk is there, the normal chalk piece, then if I have studied already about the structure, and then the chemical property or the physical property, and then the composition is nothing but what are the different type of chemical is involved for the formation of a chalk. That is nothing but the composition, we say. So study of not only the structure, not only the properties like physical, chemical, or its composition, and different variety, and later we will see the uses, functions, right? If it is a chemical of type carbon, whether it is helpful for our human beings or not. That means we study all about a single chemical, that is nothing but the chemistry, we can say. It is a branch of science which deals with the studies of, one we can say, the structure, property, composition, and their uses, their functions, their bad characters, I mean, what are the bad things, I mean, whether it is a carcinogenic, non-carcinogenic, whether it is a edible or non-edible, like everything we will see in case of what our chemistry. And after knowing about its definition and all, one we can go towards the branches of chemistry. Here, for your syllabus, we have six branches of chemistry, right? Branches means it's types, I mean, branches of chemistry, one we can say. So, here in these branches, we have six branches. Number one, we already know about three, and I will introduce three more, right? Physical. Number two, inorganic. Number three, organic. Number four, biochemistry. Number five, industrial chemistry. And number six is analytical chemistry. So these are the six different variety of branches one we can see in case of what our chemistry. For your first year syllabus, we have these many branches in our chemistry. Those are physical, inorganic, organic, biochemistry, industrial chemistry, and finally one we can say the analytical chemistry. So in the next class, we will see about their definitions and what is the importance of these branches in our chemistry, right? So with this, we will conclude this class. In the next class, if possible, please make a notes. Why? Because I am going very slow. Definitely, you can, take the notes also, right? So it will be very helpful for you. And you can save much more time, right? So with this, we will conclude this. Thank you, right?